Hi guys, Mikko here. Today is finally the day when I'm leaving Berlin. I'm all packed up and ready to go. It felt like I had a massive amount of stuff at my girlfriend's place, but now when I look at it, it's not that much, except for this guy. It's a rubber boat, or ein Schlafboot, as they say in Germany. And somehow this thing is going to fit in here. I don't know how. And I want to put it in the middle because it's quite heavy and I don't want to put too much weight on the side. I got the rubber boat as a Christmas present, and it hasn't had its maiden voyage yet. I'm excited to see when it happens. You might remember that some of my Berlin friends are inflatable boat enthusiasts. But hey, while I pack all of this inside the car, let me show you something cool from yesterday. One more play session with friends at the place that made me fall in love with Berlin. There it is. Actually fit kinda snugly in the end. I'm thinking that maybe I should do an episode where I go through all of this junk and maybe get rid of the useless stuff, because there's a lot of stuff here which I haven't used once. But hey, let me know if you would like to see like the whole inventory of shit that I have here. But that inventory is for later. Now when I'm moving back to the RV full time, I of course have to stock up on food. So let's see what I got here. Okay, well first of all, rice, of course, some onions, some sprouts or sprossen, very healthy, cucumber, zucchini, ready-made green smoothie for convenience sake, why not? Olive oil, apple cider vinegar, I plan on doing some salad dressing, tomatoes, balsamico. I've never bought balsamico in my life, but now I felt like doing it. I don't know why. Let's try out some new things, I guess. Feta cheese, paprika, lemons, 2 cans of coconut milk, bacon, because of course, broccoli to balance out the bacon, chickpeas, ginger, coconut oil, eggs for breakfast to go with the bacon, 99% dark chocolate. I love this stuff. This is almost like a drug to me. Whenever I feel tired, I just pop in a couple of these and I'm going again. It's great when I don't feel like making coffee anymore. I know that many people don't consider this 99 stuff to be even edible, but I love it. I got 3 of these. Then we have bananas and a salad mix. I think I'll be okay for a couple of days at least. Oh yeah, and I forgot. These I got earlier. I got a huge assortment of nuts from Lidl. These are great snacks on the road. I won't die of hunger. Okay, everything is packed. Now the only thing left to do is to start the engine and go. This feeling is unreal. Whoa. My next destination is Brussels, but I'll probably won't get there today. Let's see how far I feel like driving. But before the autobahn, there's one more errand we need to run. I have to fill the fresh water tank, so let's go and do that.
Hallo, ich nur Frischwasser kaufen. Frischwasser?
Nein, weil wir haben...
Alles klar.
Ja.
For some reason they didn't give me water at the camping site this time. They say that it's only for overnight customers, but... Well, I got the water tank filled here at a gas station. There's about 3 hours of autobahn behind me now. I think I'll keep driving a little bit longer until I find a nice camping spot for the night. So yeah, hey, let's talk more soon. All right. I found a nice free parking spot from a city of Magdeburg. This is a central German city near the Elbe River. For me, it felt like I drove the whole day. I checked the GPS and I drove less than 200 kilometers today. Whoa, I guess it just took forever to get out of Berlin in the rush hour traffic. But now I'm finally outside of Berlin. And hey, speaking of that, let's go to the lounge and have a little chat. First of all, leaving Berlin was way harder and way more emotional than leaving Helsinki ever was. I was quite surprised about it. This is a massive lifestyle change. Suddenly, I'm alone. I'm in a new place almost every day and I'm working. That's a big shift. When I left Finland, I had at least the video making routine going on. And also, I had planned this whole thing for 1.5 years. This time, it feels like I'm forcefully ripping myself off from the old and throwing into the new. Don't get me wrong, Berlin was amazing and there were a lot of great things, but the life, the normal day-to-day life, it didn't fly. You see, one big thing I realized recently. Back in the day when I announced the big plan, sell everything, get the RV, go surfing, people were excited about how brave I was. For me, it didn't feel like bravery. For me, it felt like the only option. But what I've realized is that this whole thing, it was like jumping off a cliff. But here's the thing. Jumping off a cliff is easy. Flying is hard. That being said, just because something is hard doesn't mean that it's not worth doing. Like, quite the opposite. I mean, like, if you're willing to flap your arms hard enough, eventually you will fly. Or actually you don't. I just realized that this metaphor is not quite waterproof. But you understand the point. Or maybe I should stop flapping my arms and start building an airplane. Yes, a much better metaphor. But hey, let's move on from the metaphors and talk about you guys. I'm so happy how well you received my previous video. The feedback was overwhelmingly positive. I had a blast replying to your comments. So much so that I want to highlight and reply to a couple of them here. Noah K writes, good to have one of the most interesting personalities on YouTube back. The adventure continues. Thank you so much, man. I can't begin to describe how motivating it is to receive comments like that. I'll do my best to keep the content interesting in the future also. This next one is more on the practical side. Axus writes, why RV? Why no caravan? Caravans are cheaper. Also, it gives the option to leave it parked and go for adventures with the car. Honestly, a caravan didn't even cross my mind. The biggest reason is that it's very difficult to spend nights outside of official camping grounds with a setup like that. I was even afraid that it's gonna be hard with a huge RV like this, but with apps like Park for Night, it's actually been surprisingly easy. But with a car plus caravan combo, I really doubt it. Then he continues that caravans have less technical problems. Second-hand RVs usually broke down on the road. Hey, if you jump into a lifestyle like this, there will be challenges, no matter what. So far, all my technical problems have been with the solar system and the heating. Normal caravan has the same systems also in one form or another. The Mercedes itself has had zero problems so far. Knock on wood. But I gotta admit, I have thought that self-built van might have been a better solution. You see, if you build it yourself, you're more familiar with every system. So if something breaks, you're more likely to be able to fix it. Then again, I had zero inspiration to build a van like that, so RV was the only option. One more comment. Cup of Rights. Are you gonna go to the hippie meeting in the middle of the field again? Rainbow Gathering. Good times. I had great fun there. And honestly, I would like to go again. The thing is, it's almost on the exact opposite side of Europe where I'm going. I wanna be surfing this summer, so I'll probably skip Rainbow this time. Also, there was a bit of controversy last time. It had a big effect on me. You see, I had just made a huge lifestyle change. I was feeling the freedom running through my veins. Then I spent a month in the forest with hippies, met some new people, got some new ideas, and then boom! My mood elevates so high that I became manic. I even began to lose my grasp on reality. And then, eventually, the mania faded away. The mood came down and the exhilarating euphoria was replaced with depression. And hey, to us bipolar people, it happens. But even more so, our day-to-day decisions have a huge effect on how those things play out. That being said, I'll probably skip Rainbow this year. From now on, my plan is to concentrate more on the airplane building and less on the arm flapping. But speaking of flapping arms, let's wrap this up. Keep those comments coming. I'll do my best to reply to every single one. Subscribe if you haven't already, and see you on Saturday. Kauppakassivideo. Aitoa tubetusta.